Okay, so February 1st, so which will be the Wednesday. So please work on the together with your, but the project scope, first project scope is the same as the what we discussed in the last week. It's you are going to implement the auction, the system using the database as a back end. Okay, regarding to the database, the only the restriction is we are going to use the Oracle database, the provided by the Scrooge Engineering. I'm not going to allow any the local database or SQL Server, the Sybase, only the Oracle database provided by the Scrooge Engineering, which means you should be able to connect from your the application to the Oracle database, which will be much, much difficult than the local database. In your the programming project, I know the some of the programming classes that use the database as a backend, then at the time you use the MySQL or the SQL Server, but this is in the local machine. So it's not very complicated to set up the connection, but for your practice, you should be able to connect from the your local the system, like your laptop or the any computer in the lab, so connect to the Oracle database in provided by the Scrooge Engineering. So you should get the message and the announcement regarding to the Oracle account. So next week we will have the first exercise slot, the February 2nd. I think that we may use the one class. Okay,
yes,
so even though we have the 29, 28, in case it's more than that, we can voluntarily ask the student to install the Oracle client, which is not complicated. Eventually, you need to, if you are using your laptop for your project, so you should install the Oracle client module to connect the Oracle server. So voluntarily, we can ask at least the three students to install and bring your laptop, then join the exercise lab. But the first project, it doesn't require it. We are going to use Erwin software for the modeling. So you don't need the Oracle connection, Oracle account. But if you are using your own laptop, please contact the GA, and the GA, you can get the DVD or the software from the Omar. Regarding to the Erwin software, they have the software.
Okay.
Then you can install for your practice also. Okay, so after we finish the chapter 3 and chapter 4, I will explain the more about the, what is Erwin software, what is the exercise lab first. Okay, this is a change of the schedule. Any question?
Remember you said that project is going to be a one-hour project
in the first class? Yeah, it's individual, but I changed my mind. It's my class. So it's for you, better for you. Okay, I usually like the group project, but I know sometimes the student use the group project. So only one student do the everything, the other student not. So I'm thinking to how to review the, like the peer review at the end of the semester to be fair, your contribution on the project. But the group project is, I know some of the student like the individual project, but I do not allow this time the individual project, okay? For the group one, so you need to work hard. The teamwork is one of the most important criteria when you search the job also, okay? So, but this time I'm not going to assign you the membership. Instead, you guys can find your the project member. And you can register, sign in. One of the group is already created on the Canvas. So if you decide the group, so it doesn't matter, group 1, group 14, there's no the difference. So once you decide, then the logon assign it to the same group. Any questions? I'm not going to allow individual project for the project 1. Any other? Okay, so let's continue so we have information. So our goal is to build the database system. So throughout the semester, we will cover the in-between, how we can make the information available in the database system. This is our goal of this advanced database design course. But before we start the first step, this one, we'd like to see a little bit more. What is this? The database management system. Database management system is what?
Software.
So software to use the database. So regarding to the database, we will discuss the mostly relational database model. Okay? However, there are a lot of different models to organize the data for the database, like the hierarchical database, object-oriented database, and the object-relational database, network database. There are a bunch of different database models. Model means it's a group of concepts. It's like the structure, how we can organize the data. Okay, so among them, we are going to use the relational database. Definitely, we will discuss a lot. What is a relational database model? How it works later. Okay, but anyway, there are other software that implement this model, that is the relational database management system. So if we cover all the details of this one, then the run how to use this, it's too late to start your project. That's the reason I'd like to introduce earlier as soon as possible regarding to the DBMS software. So there are a lot of software that implement a relational model. Don't worry, what is a relational model? We don't discuss yet, okay? Don't worry, but there are software that implement this, okay? Like the Java is the program language, one of the program languages that implement what? Object-oriented programming. Okay, it's one of the such object-oriented programming languages, C++ or the other. Okay, so similarly, Oracle is one of them. There are many other, Sybase, Infomix, DB2, SQL Server, probably more than 100,000 of the DBMS relational database management system, including very simple UB DB relational database. So the long time before, 4 or 5 years ago, in this class, the student implemented the DBMS system also. It was a very simple relational database management system. There are a lot. Among them, we will use this Oracle database management system. I'm not a big fan of this one. Instead, this is the most popular. Okay? So you may have a higher chance to use Oracle database once you graduate and join one of the real projects. Okay? That is the only reason to select this. So you are going to use the Oracle database for your practice. However, later you will realize that when you access the data in this DBMS system, relational database system, the only way to access the data is the SQL structured query language, not your Java code, not your Python code, not your PHP. The only way is the SQL. We will learn how. One, the SQL is the only way. Because due to the characteristic of the SQL, we need to combine the C++ SQL or the Java plus the SQL or the .NET plus the SQL. Okay, this is called database programming. Okay, always we need to work with the SQL to access the data. That is the problem actually. So that makes the difficulty for the database programming. Sometimes it's a security hole or the other. We will see why. So regarding to the SQL, last time we talked about there are different types of the database languages. One is data definition languages that define the data structure, create the struct, create the table, create the index, create something, alter, modify such a structure. These are called the data definition languages. In addition to this one, we have data manipulation languages. Manipulate means handle the data. Once you create the structure, we'd write to insert, we'd write to delete, we'd write to update, we write the query, such a data. This is called the data manipulation languages. So we will learn both of them later once we cover what is a relational model. Okay? Looks like that this is in your object-oriented concept. The class has the data, variable, and operation, or behavior, in your class, right? Same idea. So when we have the model, it's a structure. It defines this one. And this is the kind of operation and method. So this is the language that we are going to learn. Sometimes we have the data control languages to manage the permission. Like I create the table, I have a database, but I'd like to give the permission to other users. At that time, you can give the permission using data control languages, but we are not going to pay attention to a lot of this part. But in real life project, you need to know. So these are the data definition languages and data manipulation languages we will learn in the class also. Then, in your textbook and the slide, there is one more thing we need to discuss. This, that is the database, the architecture. So it's a kind of history of the database system architecture. It is the same as the computing environment. So long time ago means the 40 years ago, in the IT department, we had very big the system. For example, we have the database system. Okay, this database system is everything in the computer. Okay, then people would like to use the data in this database system. How? Logon, select the data. No, there is no logon. There is no connection. At that time, the network was not popular even before internet was born. So to use the, such a computing power database to access a database in this system, we need to use dummy terminal. Okay. Dummy terminal means it has only CRT monitor and the keyboard, then they are connected, directly connected to the server. Okay? Usually serial port, using the serial port is connected. Then access the database and get the data. Okay? If you have another user, it's another dummy terminal. Then access the data. Output, usually print. Printing job, like the line printer, something like that. Okay, this is called centralized database, the server. It's a centralized, everything is centralized. It's a one big the database system. It's a centralized database system. Main problem, once the database is filled, the 100% use, no way to increase the, it's not very flexible. Okay, even you cannot add another server because they cannot be connected to each other because there is no network concept at the time. Instead, you need to replace entire system by leave one, bigger one. Okay, obviously it's costly and tedious job. Sometimes you lose the data accidentally. So people think about how to address that problem. So in 1980 and beginning of 1990, so they realized that, the people had a more personal computer system, like this one is powerful. So personal computer power is high up, and plus we have finally internet. The network. So using such a benefit of the PC, powerful PC and the internet, instead of the big machine, so we can have only database. Okay? Only database. At this, the centralized system, it has the printer job. It has the application program. It has the database. Everything centralized. Okay? Because of that, it's a burden, overhead of the system. So we can take out some of the job, like the graphical user interface, some algorithm or processing to the computer, personal computer. How? Using network. So you can connect. You don't have to be next to the centralized database system. It can be remote. Then connect through the network. So like what you are using, the Oracle database at UB. So you never seen, even now I never seen the database, but you can connect using the network. If you have more user, you can do that. If you have more user, you can do that. If you, your database is full, you can add another one. Or you can replace only the database. You don't have to change the other component. Okay? So this is called, these are the client, this is the server. So client and server database environment. This architecture has been used, still being used in many of the computer systems. Okay? So we have the, like the, our the Oracle database is the server and you are client. So you are able to connect the database and get the database data. Then in your application program, you're on your laptop, you can implement your application. Okay? Even you don't know whether this database will be changed or upgraded or something happened, you don't know. You don't have to. Okay? This is a client and server environment. However, there might be a limitation to connect the number of clients. As you learned in your network class, whenever you connect, some of the resource on the server will be allocated to the connection. Okay? For example, in case of Oracle, you need 10 to 15 megabyte size of memory. Which means, if you have 100 users, you need at least 1 gigabyte of memory for the connection. If you have 1,000 users, 10 gigabyte of the memory, only for the connection. So there might be limitation. It's much more flexible than centralized, but still limited. Okay. So to address that problem, we have something in between. So we have a client. Client connect to the, this one. Then this one to the database, there is a dedicated the connection. Okay? Like the only three connections, which means whenever client one requests the job, if there is available connection, we can use the one of this. Okay? If we client 10 requests something database transaction, getting the data, then allocate one of the available connection. Okay, then from the server point of view, how many users? Only three users. But practically how many users? We can have as many users as possible, as many clients as possible. So this is called 1, 2, 3. So three tier computer architecture. It's not only for the database, but many other systems like the web server. So web server, this is a back-end database, this is a web server, and this is the user, browser, client. So how many the users are using the Google? Millions. But do you think all of them are connected to the, their database or the system? No. Only they have the Google, have the application server. This is called sometimes application server. Or sometimes it's called, because it's in the middleware. There are many different names of the brand of the such a middleware, Tuxedo, Topend, and so on. Okay? Most of nowadays web server are this middleware. Not only just web services, but also application. So middleware service. So it's called the application server. So that is service web application server. Okay? So they are doing such a thing. Okay? So this is a three-tier architecture. Database use the three-tier architecture a lot. Nowadays, it's getting moved to the, this is a server, this is client, clearly. But nowadays, there's no difference between this one and this one, the P2B. All of them are client, all of them are server, but database, we do not have the P2B type database system yet. Who knows? Maybe. But not sure. So database use mostly use this three-tier architecture. There are four-tier or n-tier, but it's based on not much difference from the three-tier architecture. So in your project, you are going to select either three-tier architecture. Most of case you are when you are using web interface. Okay? Which means database is a our OSL database provided by the Scrub engineer, not changed. But this one and client module is totally up to you. You guys will decide what program language you use or the, whether I'm going to use the middleware or not. Mostly when you are using web interface, So you need to, this one. This, we are not. I'm not going to provide this. So you need to find this one. Sometimes you can install the web server on your laptop. Okay? Then from your laptop, your web server should be able to connect the database. Or you can purchase. Like there are a lot of the available. So sometimes very cheap, sometimes a free web server. Okay? From that web server, should be able to connect up this database. It's not easy to set up. Okay? Or if you don't want to use the web interface, I'm going to create the C++ application directly connected to this one or Java application. It can be client server environment. Okay? You are going to focus on application program and should be able to connect the database. So this is the different types of the database architecture. So most of the database system is one of these. Then slightly the changes. Okay. Then so that is the end of the chapter 1 and 2. It's just introduction. So sometimes you may not understanding the may not understand the name or concept of the something like the table. I never heard about what is a table or what is a relation. Don't worry, we will discuss. This is just a quick overview of the what we are going to learn in this semester and also what you need to do in the project. Okay, I'd like to give the picture of this class so far. Then finally we are going to start to fill up this in the middle from the information to the database system. That's your goal to implement this one until the, I think the end of March. Okay, so first step. This, what is the information? It's everything, information, okay? But in terms of the data structure, it's not structured, it's not organized, okay? So it's not good for the database system, any computer system. Nowadays, this is slightly changed. Even there exists the database system that can directly manage the raw information as it is. It's an unstructured database. Sometimes it's called a NoSQL database, but we are not going to cover the NoSQL database in this class. Instead, structured, especially relational database, which means this information should fit to the relational database model, even though we do not know what is a relational model, okay? But we know this information should be organized. Okay, so first step is, still, we don't know what is the relational database, what is even computer, just conceptually. So think about you are going to clean up your room, right? Or you are going to clean up your house. When you return your home, then you try to organize. So how you can clean up your room? Sometimes you need to throw away the garbage, trash, right? You don't want to keep such a garbage unused. No, non-important thing. You can just throw away, or you can donate them. Then once you decide, I need to manage the book and clothes and something stuff. So are you going to just put all together into the closet or the desk? Instead, you'd like to collect the material, books for database course and operating system class. And also clothes, this clothes is for the spring, this clothes is for the summer. So most of the people would like to organize based on if they are relevant or similar, put together. That's much more convenient when you find your clothes. If you put all the clothes and the stuff all together in one box, where is the summer clothes? Where is the jacket? It's very hard to find. So same idea. So when we start to design the database, as we discuss, our goal is to make the data and database. What are they? These are the from the information bar, relevant and also important information. So which means we try to find some relevant and important information. Then there are many, many different ways in the software engineering class, even the programming class, you learn how to organize such a data. Okay, among them, one of the popular approach is you slightly learn in your the Java or the object-oriented class. So, name is entity. So, what is an entity? In dictionary term, entity means? In terms of Java, what is an entity? Object. Okay, we have object. Object. This is object. This is a human student. And the something stuff. So everything is object. So when you are doing the Java programming, so from the real life object, you find the student object, student object, student object. Then what is the next step? Define relation. Then you define eventually what? That will be class. Class has such attributes. Class represents such a relationship. So you define such a class. Class is more like the definition model of your the group of object. You are not going to define all details, everything information about each object. You are going to manage common object. Okay. Which is called sometimes node. Node has number of field or attribute. Same idea in the first step of the database design. So we try to find some important relevant information in terms of entity. So we try to. So instead of object, we are going to use the database term, so entity. We have the, in the information a lot of entity. This is entity. Entity, 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 I'm the entity, you are the entity, this is entity, and there are a bunch of different entity. Then we try to group by similar entity. Okay? So entity is the thing, it's the existing thing. It's not imaginary, it can be invisible, okay, sometime. Okay? What is your age? Age may not be visible, but it's the existing things. So we try to collect the such a things in terms of object-oriented concept is object. Okay? So we try to find the existing thing from the information. So eventually we are going to find the such a entity from the information. Then how many different entities? How many different objects when you are doing programming? Only one object?
No.
There are many objects, and how many classes do you define? If your information is a simple one class. But mostly it's many classes, right? The student class in this classroom, and the equipment class, and the instructor class, and there are many different classes. So we have many entity. These are the quite similar approach as other, the modeling technique, okay? In your programming class and in other. But when we manage the such the data entity, sometimes they are related. So for example, we have the student entity and instructor entity. Okay? Do I collect all the instructor entity? For example, how many instructors at UB? Maybe several hundred, okay, let's say 200. But not all of them are teaching computer science students. So I'd like to manage the computer science department information in our database. If I collect all the information about the instructor, only 20 instructors are teaching for the computer science student. Okay? And regarding to the student, how many students at UB? Nowadays, 6,000 to 7,000 students. Not all of them are computer science students. So how can we restrict them? So we try to find something, relationship between, or sometimes three, four entities. So for example, Professor Lee is teaching this student. Student one, student two, student three, only, okay? We don't need any other information. Even though they exist in real life work, they are not important. They are not relevant. Our relevant means the instructor is teaching this one. So from the information, we try to find such a thing, entity. and also their relationship. This is called entity relationship model. In short, ER model. ER modeling is not only for the database model. Okay? It can be used for your real life when you organize your stuff. So you can, when you organize your the laptop, the file, you can use the such a approach. Okay? It can be used many others. This is called conceptual modeling. So conceptual modeling is not the physical implementation. It's just conceptually, idea, how we are going to organize this information. Why? So our goal is create the database using the DBMS. They should be organized very well. But this is not organized. So we are going to move step by step. This is much better than this one, right? So organized. So that, but it's still far from here. This one is conceptual modeling, which means not doesn't require computer science. Doesn't require computer stuff, okay? It can be used for economy, it can be used for the, our real life, but it's better than this. So first step is we'd like to model using the conceptual model. However, keep in mind, what will be the most important thing when you are doing such a conceptual model, when you are doing ER model, when you are doing the information to the this model, what will be the most important part? Computer science experience, computer skill,
business model.
So business model, business. In other words, domain knowledge. Which means, so for example, if you are implementing the banking database system, you should know how bank is organized and how the banking transaction is working. If you do not understand such a thing, you cannot make. Even you cannot decide which one is relevant, which one is similar, you cannot do that. So, most important part of the such a conceptual modeling is not computer skill, it's only domain knowledge. That is the reason. So, in, you will realize that when you join the real life project after graduation, sometimes people who are doing conceptual modeling, they will get the more money, higher salary. This is very important that design everything. So at the beginning of the any project, they start with conceptual modeling. Okay? Who will be the responsible for that?
Architects.
Sometimes data architect, sometimes even though you don't know such a what is a data, what is the architecture, sometimes CPA. The accountant, the professional accountant, they can do this one. Why? Because in the company, in the any the system, what is the most important part?
Money
flow. Okay? So money flow.